Okay. Okay, so Helena, are you in charge of the slides?
Yep.
Okay. So look, my name is Gerry Watchorn, and on behalf of CEIST, we are delighted to be here to be given this opportunity to participate in this wonderful initiative, Space for Grace. I'm here with my colleague, Rob Halford, from our team. But more importantly, we're also here with Helena McKenna, our great friend and colleague from our education office, who has been the critical and very significant contributor to what we're going to do today. So our huge thanks to Helena from our education office. The theme for our Space for Grace is Lent, a doorway of renewal. And for us, that's very important. Doors are very symbolic. A closed door offers one message. An open door, like the slide there in front of us, offers us a different meaning. We can look on Lent as a burden, or we can look on Lent as a time for release, a time of beginning, a time for refreshment, a time for renewal. And I notice I'm in a house where it's a modest house, but there's an awful lot of blinds that have to be individually pulled up every morning. And, you know, the gas thing is, at this time of year, when you pull up the blinds each morning and, you know, you give thanks, here I am again, another day, there's more light. There's daffodils popping their heads up above the ground and other little flowers. And you see the birds and the robins busy nesting and all sorts of things happening anew. So spring is in the air. And that's why this theme of Lent, a time of renewal, is an important opportunity for us to look at what we can do at this time of year to renew ourselves in the face of God and in the face of our Lord Jesus. The doorways that we refer to are very symbolic structures and have big, big significance in our lives. In the Bible, I think it says there's 180 references, if I'm correct, to doorways. Many of the verses pertain to closed doors, but some of them also, quite a lot of them, to open doors. And we see some of them there on the screen. I know your works. Behold, I have set before you an open door which no one is able to shut. Matthew, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it will be opened to you. Oh my God, how many times have we recounted that in our own mind, particularly when we're in a wee bit of difficulty or when we're looking for something. Revelation, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come to him and eat with him and he with me. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, he will be saved and will go in and out and find pasture. So just some of those indications throughout the Bible where we see this reference to a door. An open door is a symbol of a new beginning. It's a symbol of an opportunity. It's a symbol of change. And an open door showed that there's a way out. And on can also provide a view of what lies ahead. If you're trapped or if you're in difficulty or if you want to get away from where you are, you leave the room, you go through a door and it takes you to somewhere else. An open door can be a symbol of opportunity. The season of Lent is a wonderful time. It's the preparation for Easter. It's that time when we naturally reflect on our lives and what it is that we must try to do and to do better to be more worthy of the Easter message. And perhaps we can see this Lent as an open door. It is a season of some burden in that we are always encouraged to sacrifice something, but we want you to think about it perhaps as a season of opportunity, a season for renewal in yourself and in your thoughts and in your work and in how you deal with other people. An opportunity for us to reflect and to grow in our awareness of God's presence in our lives. And we probably ask the question, as we will in the next slide, if you look at Lent in this way, what door is God opening in your life today? And it's a simple enough little statement, but if we address it in terms of all those wonderful moments of our ordinary lives that can be gracefully extraordinary, what door is God opening in your life today if you were to look towards it? So, Lord Jesus, gather us. Gather our thoughts and hearts to you. You are the source of hope and goodness. As we come to you, we realize that we have been distracted by many things. Guide our thoughts, our hearts, our lives as we turn to you this Lent, and we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Gerry. I'd like to read a reading now from John, the Gospel. Jesus said, "I am the door. If anyone enters through me, he will be saved, and he will go in and out and find pasture." Jesus said, "I tell you the truth, the man who does not enter the sheep pen by the gate, but climbs in by some other way, is a thief and a robber. The man who enters by the gate is the shepherd of his sheep. The watchman opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes on ahead of them, and his sheep follow him because they know his voice. But they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will run away from him because they do not recognize a stranger's voice." Jesus used this figure of speech, but they did not understand what he was telling them. Therefore, Jesus said again, "I'll tell you the truth. I am the gate for the sheep. All who ever came before me were thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. He will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that we may have life and have it to the full. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep."
Now, we have a short video presentation, which we hope you will really enjoy. It pulls together some various themes affecting our world: war, poverty, famine, climate change. We hope it provides an opportunity for each of us to reflect on the issues at hand and how we can play our part.
Thank you.
Our response is, we turn to you, O Lord. From anger and doubt, we turn to kindness and hope.
We turn to you, O Lord.
From violence, we turn to peace.
We turn to you, O Lord.
From name-calling and bad treatment of others, we turn to love one another.
We turn to you, O Lord.
From selfish acts, we turn to generosity of spirit.
We turn to you, O Lord.
From unfairness and prejudice, we turn to justice and equality.
We turn to you, O Lord.
From material wealth, we turn to the riches of your kingdom.
We turn to you, O Lord.
And from popularity contests, we turn to being our real selves.
We turn to you, O Lord.
Romans 12:2. A renewed mind leads to a transformed life. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Let us pray. For those places in the world that have been affected by war, we remember in particular the people of Ukraine and pray for an end to war. We pray that individuals, communities, and governments can work together to address the root causes of war, poverty, and inequality in order to achieve a just world for all.
We pray to the Lord.
Loving God, we thank you for the gift of learning. We pray for children who cannot attend school due to conflict, natural disasters, and emergencies. May we always appreciate the gift of learning as a way to build a brighter future for all.
We pray to the Lord.
We pray for the people of Syria and Turkey who have been left grief-stricken, injured and homeless following the devastated earthquake recently. May our Lenten almsgiving serve to ease the suffering and injustice faced by these people and others around the world.
We pray to the Lord.
For your gift of the earth to us, O Lord, that we may have a renewed sense of respect for our common home. Help us to realize the effects our choices have on the world around us and to work for climate justice at home and abroad.
We pray to the Lord.
Judge not and ye shall not be judged. It's a wonderful, wonderful quotation from Luke's gospel. And I just even in that slide show that Helena put together for us there with the video, there was one wonderful slide by a group of people who said, we are not bad people. And we're hoping that in our own efforts across Lent, that we are going to be less judgmental in how we see people, in how we meet people, and in how we interact with people. This Lent, we hope to look deeper into the people we meet. Grant us the wisdom and understanding to be more non-judgmental in the interactions that we have over Lent. If you don't mind going ahead, Helena. Let us pray that we will try harder to show love in all the things that we say and do, and in all the choices that we make during this season of Lent. May we always be people of love and forgiveness. As we journey through Lent, may we become closer to God and learn to live in a new way. As we remember your death, Jesus, we know that it was a sign of God's great love for us. Live in our hearts this Lent and help us to share this love with our families, friends, and everyone that we meet. For forgiveness, dear God, we pray today to ask your forgiveness for the times when we turned away from your love. Give us the courage to be honest with ourselves and to see ourselves as we truly are. May we try to see the best in the people we meet today. Give us the strength to try to let go of the hurt, forgive them, and move on. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For family, what does my family need this Lent? What kind of family member am I? Am I a peacemaker? Am I grateful for everything that my family does for me? Do I contribute? Loving God, I pray for my family today. Watch over all of us. Keep us safe. Help our home to be a place of peace and love. We remember families who are in difficulty. because of addiction, unemployment, and or violence, and protect them and keep them safe. We pray to the Lord and say that great prayer, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, that we may forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus said, everything is possible for one who believes. And I suppose as we come to the end, we just want to read this short story, which I think reflects how each of us can make a difference. One day, a man was walking along a beach when he noticed a boy picking up something and gently throwing it into the ocean. Approaching the boy, he asked, "What are you doing?" The youth replied, "Throwing starfish back into the ocean. The surf is up and the tide is going out. If I don't throw them back, they'll die." "Son," the man said, "don't you realize there are miles and miles of beach and hundreds of starfish? You can't make a difference." After listening politely, the boy bent down, picked up another starfish and threw it back into the surf. Then, smiling at the man, he said, "I made a difference for that one." As we come to the end, may each of us recognize our opportunity to make a difference to others in some small way. We pray today that our presence, behavior, and action will give witness and allow others to encounter Christ. We ask this in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
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 So our sincere thanks for your time with us this afternoon. Again, our thanks especially from all in the CEIST team to Helena for all you do for us in all these matters and other matters, and to your colleagues there also in our office in Chéile, Helena. We depend and value everything that you all do for us. We hope you have enjoyed our short gathering. Our hope for you today is that you can appreciate in all our ordinary lives the extraordinary gifts that we have to be able to make differences, real differences in the lives of others, in the moments that we share with them. And that, as like myself, when we pull up those blinds each and every day, particularly during the season of Lent, we can give thanks to God for the opportunities we have in our own lives. And remember, at some point and each and every day, Jesus said yes. And because of that, we are all saved. Thank you. Thank you for your attention.